Wasseim's big dream was to run a barbering business out of a mobile truck. But it was a dream cut short when he was shot and almost died in the Christchurch mosque shootings. It's been a year since that day when 51 precious lives were lost. Tonight, as the anniversary approaches, stories of survival, courage and starting over. So let's begin with Wasseim and the untold story of the man who saved his life. This from Janet McIntyre.
Well, how have you been, my friend?
Good, bro. Yeah, busy. How about you?
When it's a cutthroat blade at your neck, you have to be able to trust your barber.
He's one of the best barbers in New Zealand.
This is a trust forged in blood.
Until I got out of my truck, then I started to hear the gunshots. I walked back down towards it.
You walked towards the gunshots?
Yeah. But sort of... I suppose I felt it was, I don't know, like my duty to help, I suppose. Yeah, like any good person, if they see something like that happening, you want to do what you can.
Barber Wasseim was on the ground, shot. He needed someone, anyone, to come to his aid.
I was yelling for help, and I saw Lance from a way distance. And he come all the way, running.
How did he pick you up?
Just like a little boy, like with two hands.
And now the two are best of mates.
It suits you short on the back and side because, man, you're getting old, man.
Yeah, yeah, that's it, I know. Tell me about it.
And meet to the Prophet Musa alayhi salam in the sixth heaven. Musa says...
Wasseim Sati, a husband and father of four, brought his family from Jordan to Christchurch in 2014, where he planned to start a mobile barber business out of this truck.
Guys. Okay, wait, okay. Yep.
He got the truck just days before the shootings.
I'm very blessed, guys. I'm so happy, yes, hey!
The dream was to have a barber truck and go around New Zealand. It's cutting here as a barber. That's what I am good at it. I win the New Zealand rewards for the last 3 years.
But Wasseim and his family's life changed forever on March 15th last year. We can't tell you the full extent of the tragedy they endured because of legal restrictions. But we can tell you that Wasseim was shot 3 times and might have died, if not for Lance Bradford.
Yeah, I was driving down Dean's Ave and yeah, that's when I came across it.
Lance, a self-employed skylight installer, just happened to be passing the Al Noor Mosque in his ute.
When I drove past the mosque, I saw people lying on the ground and running, and it wasn't until I got out of my truck then I started to hear the gunshots. Yeah, so that's when I started to sort of go down and find out what was going on.
What sort of scene was that?
Pretty horrific. Never seen people shot before. I didn't really know what was going to happen.
Why did you go into that scene? A lot of people would run.
I don't know, make myself useful. Yeah, just did what I could do, but yeah, did what most people I think would do if they knew what was happening.
Amid the chaos, Lance spotted Wasseim lying on the street.
What state was he in?
Shock. Yeah, he was in a lot of pain and he was really scared about what was happening and yeah.
He picked me up, I'm like, I'm gonna fall. But he's so strong.
How much do you weigh, Wasseim?
95.
Really?
Yeah, 95. Ah, because
it didn't feel like that. Just lifted him up and carried him. He wasn't too keen on being carried.
And he put me in the first seat, and then he saw someone else injured. And he just went very quickly, grabbed him and set him in the back seat, and he drove.
I was basically tooting my horn the whole time and just going as fast as I could.
With 3 injured people in his ute, Lance took the shortest route to hospital.
I went down Hagley Ave the wrong way and drove over the curb and over the park and kind of onto Hagley Ave.
What did you think of his driving?
Ah, he was a movie driver. It was like a movie.
So,
and I was scared. I'm like, yeah, go. And he was like, yeah, I am.
Minutes later, Lance, with his bleeding passengers, arrived in the hospital ambulance bay to shocked staff.
The news was probably just breaking out at that point. I didn't know what was happening. He was just guy in a red ute. just rocked up and, yeah. So I think it was a bit of a surprise for them.
Lance went back to the scene two more times to help. All three people he rescued survived, as did others, like Tamel Atachuju, shot 9 times.
5 bullets on my legs and shot in my mouth and then 3 and on my arms, you know.
And you could still walk.
Yeah, and then I managed to walk out.
With 9 bullets?
With 9 bullets, yeah.
What have doctors said about the fact that you did survive?
They're thinking I'm a very lucky man. Lucky cat, hey? They have 9 lives, so I don't have any more life left.
Hi guys, how are you?
The day after the shooting, Wasseim posted this video from his hospital bed on Facebook.
I'm very sorry to miss your calls and text messages. I will not be able to answer any one of you now. I am really tired. Just stand
up in front of. He received more than 1 million responses.
How long did it take you to read those?
I'm still going through. I haven't finished a few hundreds.
And they're all strangers?
The majority from New Zealand, but a lot of them from all over the place.
His recovery has been slow and painful. 12 operations and months in hospital in Christchurch and Auckland.
It is major surgery. You've already been for a lot with yourself and your family, obviously. We'll get you up and walking tomorrow.
It's 1 year, can you believe it?
It's the quickest year ever, and it's the longest year that I had in my life.
Seeing Wasseim struggling, seeing his story, seeing everything that's happened to him, it's about time that someone reached their hand out to give him a hand.
It's not just the suffering, but the resilience of victims like Wasseim that inspired Jordan Garvin, a signwriter who kept noticing Wasseim's big and bare mobile barber truck.
I was driving past it every day on the way home, and I was actually going to put a business card on his driveway, and then, we heard about this story, and, we just made it happen.
So Jordan and the team at Identity Signs in Sockburn spent weeks working for free on unique artwork that would make Wasseim's truck unmissable.
So generous of you. Why have you done this?
Basically, we like to be part of the community, lend a helping hand here and there. But a big part of our business is to actually make people succeed, give people a new lease of life. And I think that's what we're about as people of Christchurch, is we really like to help each other.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God, look at that.
Wow, people aren't gonna miss that.
Oh my God. It's more than what I suspect.
Yeah?
Look at that. Oh, my truck. Thank you so much, guys.
God, help the brother. Thank you, man. I really appreciate that.
An act of terror designed to drive people apart.
I really appreciate that.
Has, for some, created connections, goodwill, things to live for.
Good to see you, my friend.
Look after me, eh?
I will.
Tamel, shot 9 times.
I have to be patient about my recovery. I can say I'm alive because of it's a miracle for me.
He's gonna be forever barber for me.
Hey, bro.
And Lance Bradford too is now a customer, and much more.
Yeah, did what any good person would do. You do the same for me, so it's.
He's our family hero. He's our family hero.
The more we see each other, bro, it'll help.
So lovely. Lance Bradford, that humble hero who says he did no more than anyone else in the minutes after the attack.